from KPRC Channel 2. This is Houston Newsmakers with Cambrell Marshall.
You've seen him and his commercials all over local airwaves, on TV, in person. Attorney Tony Busby threw his hat into the ring to run for Houston mayor in a big way, declaring that he would use his own money to fund his campaign. Why? So that voters would know that he would not owe anyone anything. Those donors who give him money, if elected, he wanted to know he was clean and above all of that. Well, he made the runoff and now has a chance to realize his goal of becoming Houston mayor. Tony Busby's here this morning to talk about the road on his journey so far and the challenges ahead as he moves toward the December 14th election day against Mayor Sylvester Turner. Good morning. Thanks
Good
for
morning.
Stopping by.
Thank you for having me.
Good to see you.
Good to be here.
This race, you spent a lot of money on this race.
Yes, I have.
Has it been worth it?
We'll find out soon enough. One thing that's been very gratifying is the amount of support that we've been able to get. And, you know, the city of Houston is 664 square miles. Mm. It's community after community after community. And to be able to meet, you know, we all go around our little bubble. You know, we all have the, you know, we go to the same grocery store, we go to the same restaurants. And when you campaign in a city of this magnitude that's so sprawling, from Kingwood to Clear Lake, West Houston, and all the great communities that we have, you learn a lot, and it's been very satisfying.
As a first-time politician, what has it taught you? I mean, it certainly is a whole different perspective, isn't it, when you see all those pockets of those communities, many of them you wouldn't have gotten into
right?
if you weren't out running for office.
No, it puts you in a fishbowl, that's for sure. You know, I've always been in the public eye just in my law practice and the kind of cases that I pursued, but you know, you have no privacy, whatever. Everybody that drives by my house yells out. But it's been a really rewarding experience. And the only bad thing about it is, you know, there's always what we call haters out there that will hate no matter what you do. You could save the Pope and people will be mad at you.
Yeah.
And I hate that my children were exposed to that. But beyond that, I would do it again.
Let's talk about the hill that you got to climb to win this race. Last month when the votes were all counted, you were 18 and a half points, percentage points behind.
That's right.
The mayor. Bill King was a big distance drop down, then Dwight Boykins. And the one thing I noticed about all of this is that the rest of the candidates total make up only 5% of the vote.
That's right.
So between now and the election coming up, somehow we got to get some numbers that's going to make a difference. Where do you get those numbers from? How do you motivate people to get out
and vote? It's all about the turnout. Yeah. It's all about, if you think the city is on the wrong track, you got to get off your couch and go vote. It's so frustrating that we have people that will camp out at 5 in the morning and stand in line to get an iPhone or to go to a concert or to get a Popeye's chicken sandwich or In-N-Out.
Yeah.
But yet we can't get them to vote when it takes 1 minute to cast their vote and make their voice heard. So to make that up, you know, and of course I've been an underdog my entire life. To make that up, we absolutely have to get people to vote.
So you do understand this is an underdog kind of position.
No doubt about it.
And you're comfortable with that, or maybe not comfortable, but you know what the deal is, you know what you have to do.
That's why we have 100 people in our campaign office right now on the telephone. That's why we have 100 people block walking as we speak. You know, we know what it takes. It's just a matter of making it happen.
You keep an eye on the other guy to see what he's doing?
I don't pay attention to him. You know, he's had 4 years. This mayor has had 4 years to make our city go. He has not made our city go. He's had 4 years to do something about flooding. He hasn't done anything. He's had 4 years to deal with crime. He hasn't done it. He hasn't gotten the job done. Our focus now is to put our message out there, put ourselves out there, get our people to the polls, and hopefully win this election.
And you said he hasn't done anything, but certainly some things have been done. You just think that they haven't been done to the level that they should be done.
He claims he's a CEO. I'll just say it like this. You know, he says, you know, judge me as a CEO. Mm-hmm. Well, if he were a CEO of any company that I owned, he would be fired.
You talk about in a lot of the promotional, the ads that you've had in your public appearances about the things that have not gone right, the things that the failings of the mayor. I noticed in the recent commercials since the runoff period has started, you've actually started talking about more about things. Okay, we know from my standpoint what the mayor's not doing. This is what I'm going to do. What are the things that you're going to really focus on doing that you think will make a big difference?
We have committed, we published a 100-day plan. These are the things we absolutely will accomplish in 100 days, which includes kickstarting our our flood mitigation efforts, talking to the governor and getting those flood mitigation funds back here so we can put those funds to work to prevent flooding going forward. We've talked about putting more police officers on the streets. We've talked about paying the firefighters. So we have a very detailed, you know, to get to the runoff with 12 candidates, that's a tough road mm-hmm. to hoe, as we say in East Texas. And we made it. Now I think people, they understand that there's some failings in City Hall. They want to hear what we can do going forward, and that's what we've been focused on.
The Firefighters Union came out very quickly to endorse you. They said, you know, and you made it a point not to seek endorsements, right. But they came out and endorsed you anyway. I don't know that that means an awful lot. I mean, Dwight Boykins had their endorsement as well. He barely got 6%.
That's 6%.
Yeah.
You know, Dwight's a great guy and a friend of mine, but I would respectfully submit that 6% was because of the firefighters working their tail ends off for him, and that 6% could swing this election.
You had talked about their promises the mayor's made that he's been broken. What are some of those that you suggested he's done that has not kept?
Well, he said he would put 600 more police officers on the street. He did not do that. He said that he would turn dirt on these flood mitigation issues. He hasn't done that. He's helped 15 people in more than 2 years that were crushed by Hurricane Harvey. You know, we're going to have a press conference later today, and we're going to talk about six or eight of his. And the thing is, the press conference, we can't have it go too long because I could spend most of the day talking about the promises that he has broken to the city of Houston. But those are some of the big ones there.
If you had a chance to talk with him face to face, I noticed that there've not been any debates.
He's ducked out. We had two scheduled. He's canceled both of them. And that's very frustrating because I think this is a job interview, and the people expect the two candidates after this long campaign to be able to sit in the same room and talk about the issues, and he refuses to do so.
If you had an 18-point lead over somebody who's going into a general election, would you find yourself wanting to debate?
If I had spent 4 years as the mayor and I thought I'd done a good job, I'd beat down every door to go tell people how good of a job I've done. I wouldn't duck it. That's what he's doing.
Well, I invite all of you to go to clicktohouston.com. You can click on Houston Newsmakers Extra to see more of our interview. We're going to continue talking here about what you would say, yeah. Some of the details about what's going to be going on in this next few weeks, and all about what you want for viewers to know. When they go to the polls, they've got a little bit to make up their mind. What do you tell them?
Yeah, I mean, if you're happy with the way Houston is going, then you know, you have your choice. But if you want to change and you want our city to be on the map where we're considered in the national conversation, where they talk about the great cities of Houston or Texas or the great cities of the United States, then you have a choice. I'm going to be the mayor for everybody. Everybody's going to have a seat at the table, and we're going to take things to a higher level.
Remember, Houston Newsmakers Extra on clicktohouston.com, the Newsmakers page, for more of our conversation. I'd hope to provide equal opportunity for Mayor Turner on this program as well, but the mayor has declined my invitation.